An election watchdog calls for various reforms to make Philippine elections peaceful and accessible to voters. Lito Averia, chair of the National Citizens Movement for Free Elections, or NAMFREL, calls for laws banning political dynasties to reduce the number of election-related violence in the country. He adds anti-dynasty provisions are only present in the law establishing youth councils and the Bangsamoro Electoral Code. Averia also urges COMELEC to make the voting process easier, especially for vulnerable sectors and absentee voters.
We have to make it easy for the voters to vote. So if voters like you, for example, you go on early voting, right?
Mm.
So, but you're only able to vote for national positions and not the local positions. So we have to address that issue.
Mm.
Second is we have to address the convenience, for example, of the elderly. I saw some voters yesterday. That when I got to the APP, there were about 30, maybe 40 elderly voters already in the APP waiting for their ballots.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to address the convenience also of the elderly voters. I think the eldest I saw yesterday was about 84, 85 years old already.
Wow.
And what is surprising is that early in the morning, the first hour, there were a lot of elderly voters,
mm.
the senior citizen voters that were there.
Mm-mm.
Right? So they still really do want to exercise their right to vote.
Yeah.
But we have to make it convenient for them.
The Philippine poll body clarifies 7 villages experienced delays in holding their elections. COMELEC earlier said all polling precincts were able to hold elections, but 5 villages in Lanao del Sur experienced delays in the delivery of election paraphernalia. 3 of the 5 are only holding their elections today. In Samar, elections were postponed in 2 towns after a group of insurgents allegedly fired at the contingent delivering election paraphernalia. Additional military and police personnel have been deployed to those areas. COMELEC also vowed to investigate the incidents and go after the people behind the delays. Meanwhile, the COMELEC is looking to file cases against members of the electoral board and police personnel who withdrew from service on election day.
That is a totally unacceptable. And sabi nga po ng isang commissioner, eh kung hindi mo kaya yung trabaho, eh bakit mo sana sinabi mo na kaagad? Hindi yung kung kailan mag-i-election, tsaka natin gagawin. Immediately after the election, we got their names kanina. Yung mga lahat ng personnel ng DepEd, personnel ng PNP, kahit personnel ng Commission Election, eh, hindi po namin palalagpasin yung mga infractions po na yan.
The Israeli government confirms it has been promoting online ads containing graphic material that somehow found their way into children's video games. Reuters is reporting cases in Brazil and in Europe of online games being interrupted to show footage of Hamas militants' attack. Israel's foreign ministry confirmed the video is government-funded, but denied knowledge on how it ended up on various games. It says the footage is part of a larger media campaign by Israel. It also insisted officials told advertisers to block the content for users below 18. Over 1.7 million Afghan refugees to be sent back to their home country as Pakistan cracks down on undocumented immigrants within its borders. The deportation threat stems from suicide bombings this year, which the government claims involves Afghans without providing any evidence. Islamabad's plans have alarmed the UN Refugee Agency, UNHCR, saying it will put female refugees in particular at risk. Around 700,000 Afghan refugees arrived in Pakistan's borders in 2021 after Kabul fell to the hands of the Taliban. Meanwhile, there are less passengers than expected in some of the Philippines' main transport hubs. The Ninoy Aquino International Airport reported no major congestion in its terminals. Manila's main airport saw only around 118,000 passengers last Monday, which is lower than the initial 120,000 to 130,000 forecast. And to mark Halloween, some airline staff even took the time to dress up as various characters. Meanwhile, the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange also seeing normal operations with some 100,000 passengers. The transport terminal anticipates that the influx of passengers will begin on November 4 Saturday and could last until November 6 Monday. Over at the Batangas port, only about 1,200 passengers have passed through, heading to Mindoro and Trombolon. Port management anticipates returning passengers will start coming in starting Wednesday night. The Philippine government's outstanding debt dips in September to 14.27 trillion pesos. That amount is 80 billion pesos lower than the previous month's level, primarily due to net repayments of both domestic and external obligations. The Treasury Bureau says debt payments surged by 57% from January to September. The nine-month debt payments amounted to 1.4 billion pesos. That's significantly higher than the nearly 890 billion posted last year. Potato lovers in the Philippines may soon have to pay more for the commodity. After the previous rise in onion, sugar, and even egg prices, the Agriculture Department now says potatoes are next. The agency's spokesperson told a government briefing the increase is due to recent typhoons that hit the country. They now expect potato prices to stabilize by the first quarter of next year. As for other basic goods, the agency says prices are expected to remain stable in the final months of 2023.
Ito ay naging epekto noong mga nakdaang bagyo. Medyo tumataas ng konti, but we're expecting nitong November, December hanggang pagpasok nitong first quarter ay magiging stable na uli yung presyo ng ating patatas.